You've seen them. Chances are you've explored them quite a bit yourselves, but what exactly is a forest? A forest is defined as a plant community, predominantly of trees and other woody vegetation growing close together. So of course, when we think of forest, we think of trees, but forests are so much more. Typically, you'll have a multitude of tree species, both coniferous and deciduous, but you'll also have a layer of shrubs. As you get closer to the ground, you'll have forbs, which are flowering plants, ferns, mosses, lichens, plants big and small that together make up a forest. So all of these things that I just mentioned, of course, are living entities, living organisms. But forests also include some non-living items, some abiotic components that used to be living, of course, such as downed limbs and downed logs on the forest floor. What used to be living. One of the things that we'll find is that the dead stuff in the forest, known as woody debris, the downed limbs, the downed logs, even standing dead trees, such as snags, are a vital component of the forest. We'll find that the dead stuff in a forest is the very foundation of life in the forest because it provides a basis for nutrient cycling, it contributes greatly to wildlife habitat, and keeps forest succession and a healthy forest operating. Those entities, those characteristics I just talked about, non-living and living, you have components of a forest that are large in size, small in size, living and dead. Collectively, these contribute to what is called forest structure. A healthy forest is a very structured forest, and we'll take a closer look at forest structure next. Okay. We've just talked about forest structure. We've mentioned that word structure, but what exactly does structure mean? Think about the variety of components you have in a forest. Living components, non-living components. The smallest leaf to the largest tree. What are the various shapes and sizes of those different entities? Now, don't just think of their shapes. Think about their position in relation to one another. How far apart are they from one another? How high or low are they in the forest floor? For instance, the woody debris you see in the background. Some of that is on the ground, some of it exists very high. The spatial arrangement of all of these different entities in the forest contributes to what is called forest structure. It's all the various shapes, sizes, and positions of all those elements in the forest. A highly structured forest is a very healthy forest. So these different entities in the forest, they exist at different levels of the forest. When forest elements exist at different levels, it creates what are called canopy levels in the forest. So a highly structured forest also has different canopy levels. Not all of the trees, in other words, exist at the same height. You'll have tall trees, shorter trees, even some of the snags, which are tall standing dead trees, will exist in various shapes and sizes. So think again about this dead stuff in the forest. It used to be thought that all of this dead stuff in the forest was nothing but a nuisance, a fire hazard. But only fairly recently have people started to realize the value, the extreme value of that downed material, that woody material in the forest, because it provides a great deal of habitat for wildlife and it serves as the basis for nutrient cycling. This forest that we're visiting today is in relatively good shape. A healthy, vigorous, structured forest. And that's what healthy forests are. They are highly structured, can contain many different components. If you were to come back and visit this forest maybe 100 years from now, would it look the same? If it's a healthy forest now, will it remain a healthy forest? Well, things will probably be a lot different if you return 100 years from now, because healthy forests are highly structured, contain many different components, are vigorous, but they're also always changing. Forests are not static, they're dynamic. Plant communities are always changing and they're always evolving. This contributes to what is called forest succession. Plant communities changing as we proceed from year to year, from decade to decade, and from century to century. So chances are the forest you see here will look quite different 100 years from now due to a variety of reasons and a variety of circumstances.